Covering a steep hillside in inland Turkey, visible from space, is a bright white blanket of rock more than a kilometer across. But get closer and you can see that it's made of intricate rock formations, filled with warm white waters like a partially petrified waterfall. This is Pamukkale. Its striking appearance, along with the supposedly curative waters of the hot springs that feed it, have attracted people for millennia. But this place has more to offer than just a few pics for the gram. Scientists are now teasing out Pamukkale's petrified secrets to look hundreds of thousands of years back into Earth's history. The unique site of Pamukkale can be found in western Turkey, about 200 kilometers inland from the Mediterranean coast. You can spot it from more than 30 kilometers out. Its Turkish name translates to Cotton Castle, thanks to the snow-white terraces, pools, and wall-like structures that are stacked up the hillside like a castle or opulent palace. But despite appearances, this palace isn't made from cotton, rather from a material called travertine. Limestone rock typically forms at the bottom of tropical oceans, and you often find fossils of long-dead sea creatures. Chemically, travertine is the same basic substance, but this particular type of limestone forms in the open air, and typically much faster than your usual seafloor strata, accumulating up to several millimeters per day, depending on the location. This hard, compact limestone rock is deposited when freshwater springs emerge from underground, carrying a high concentration of dissolved calcium and carbonate ions. As the water evaporates, calcium carbonate is left behind. Travertine is bright white when it's first deposited, but it turns a light yellowish-brown color when it dries out and eventually weathers to gray or black. It's most often hot springs that produce travertine, and Pamukkale is no exception. The site is located on the northern margin of the Denizli Basin, which is an active fault zone. The floor of the basin to the south has dropped along a series of geological faults, leaving a roughly 100-meter-high escarpment. Because of the stress and cracking of the rock, groundwater in the area penetrates a long way down, passing through limestone rocks that supply calcium and coming close to molten magma deep underground. This magma not only heats up the subterranean water, but it also supplies a ton of extra dissolved carbonate. Magma itself is usually pretty gassy, and carbon dioxide dissolves into the passing water. And when limestone is heated up, extra carbon dioxide is baked out of the rock and also dissolves in groundwater. So when the water makes its way back to the surface, it's about 35 degrees Celsius, just a little less than body temperature, and it's packed with the ingredients to make travertine. It emerges as springs from fissures along the fault line and flows down the escarpment to the valley below, creating some pretty special travertine formations along the way. There are six main types of travertine structures, five of which can be found at Turkey's Cotton Castle, and all of which have been built up over thousands of years. Let's take a look at three of the coolest. Terraced mounds and pools are the most visually striking formations, which draw people to this site from all over. They're created as water emerges from individual springs and flows over the surface of a mound. Travertine growth starts around tiny changes in slope, twigs, stones, and other travertine structures. The spring water collects, and limestone is deposited around its edges, creating and building a rim that encloses a pool, and these pools range from centimeters to a few meters across. Water continuously flows from the springs, ultimately building a series of terraces made from overlapping cup-shaped pools, often with stalagmite-like columns around their walls from the overflowing water. Next up, fissure ridge travertines form when spring water emerges from an elongated fissure rather than a single point. The limestone builds up in wedge-shaped layers, creating ridges either side of the fissure and also filling up the fissure itself. Despite not being much to look at on the surface, they represent large, pretty consistent deposits of the limestone rock, and they've been quarried for building and decorative stone since ancient times. Finally, self-built channels are a structure that's unique to Pamukkale, and in their own way, they're as spectacular as the terraced pools. They start as spring water flowing in a narrow stream, which can either be natural, like the overflow from an existing travertine pool, hole or mound, or they can be man-made, like the channels cut to supply water for irrigation. In the stream, water flows more slowly and turbulently at the edges compared to the middle, leading to continuous travertine deposition on the channel sides. Over time, these elevated rims grow, creating steep-sided, raised channels up to 10 meters high. They're often wavy, following the natural flow of water, but otherwise look just like the defensive walls of some ancient ruined castle. Pamukkale is undoubtedly beautiful, but its intricate travertine formations also have a lot to tell us about the past. We know that the limestone has been accumulating here for at least 400,000 years. Tiny amounts of uranium trapped among the calcium carbonate give scientists a way to determine the age of its layered deposits, as they measure how much of the radioactive element has decayed. This then allows them to track physical and chemical changes in the rock through time, giving insight into the ancient Earth environment, including paleoclimate and past earthquake activity. Travertine is made from calcium carbonate, which contains carbon and oxygen. Both of these elements have more than one stable isotope, meaning there are both heavy and light versions of carbon and oxygen floating around in Earth's air, water, and crust. Now, the ratios of heavy to light isotopes are known to vary in the environment depending on the ambient temperature. You get more lightweight carbon and oxygen when it's warm and wet, and more heavy carbon and oxygen when it's cold and dry. And that's because the heavy elements are, well, heavier. So when it's cold and there's not much energy to evaporate water in the environment, these isotopes are preferentially left behind. So by measuring the isotope ratios in successive layers of travertine, you can use them to track temperature and rainfall over hundreds of thousands of years. And analysis of thick travertines nearby in the Dinnesley Basin has revealed some pretty big climate fluctuations, with 3 sharp drops in temperature within just 100,000 years. But while these shifts were taking place in the atmosphere, there were changes happening beneath the surface too. Turkey sits on the Anatolian tectonic plate, which is being squeezed out of the way as Africa and Arabia crash northwards into Eurasia. As a result, the country experiences complex tectonic forces. It's riddled with faults and has been host to some of the most devastating earthquakes since records began. And it turns out travertines are a great way to track earthquake activity through prehistory. The limestones are most often found along faults and fractures in extensional tectonic settings. In other words, they crop up when the crust breaks because it's being pulled apart. And the shape of the travertine formations depend on the stiffness and movement of the underlying rock. For instance, fissure ridge travertines tend to form between 2 fault lines that don't quite line up, and the angles of the travertine layers can be used to figure out local stretching directions. Then, combining this with the radioactive element dates allows geologists to figure out if the stretching happened gradually or in big earthquake-causing ruptures. Not only that, but self-built travertine channels can get fractured during earthquakes, causing vertical steps of more than half a meter and sideways offsets of up to a meter. Since bigger displacement usually means bigger earthquakes, these offsets can be used to estimate the size and destructive power of past seismic events, as well as how often destructive earthquakes can be expected in the region. One study found that a magnitude 6.5 earthquake is likely to strike Western Turkey and Pamukkale roughly every 130 years. And since there was a pretty big one in the area in 1899, we might expect to see another one fairly soon. So not only is Pamukkale a uniquely beautiful geological and archaeological wonder, but it contains a valuable petrified slice of our planet's climatic and tectonic history, allowing us to understand and prepare for the future too.